Help! I'm trapped inside this thing! Stay tuned. I'm going to show you how to make this full fitness trainer. There's 40 exercises you can do. It fits Uncle Bill's requirements for fitness equipment in the fact that it's small. It doesn't take up much room. Love you all. Stay tuned. We're going to have fun. Go Gear Fitness, full body fitness trainer, 40 plus different workouts. Let's open it up. We have the full fitness trainer. Big instruction manual and information on setting it up. That's going to be interesting. I'm going to read through that. Tools. These are, we're going to match these up. These will be the curl bars that you see here. There's one, two of those. Then we have, sticker's stuck. It says, warning, maximum 250 pounds. So if you're over 250 pounds, don't use this thing. At least not as a chin-up bar. You could use it as a sit-up. And another bar. Shouldn't take too long to put this together. What's this? This is the foot bar, which they have some instructions on. All right, box out of the way. Ooh, I like this. This go to our assembly directions here. Step one, we take these two and we put them together. Okay, one, two, they're together. There's the threaded side, there's the holes, and we match it up. Chase down our parts to this, which will be 63, which is numbered right here, 63 and 60, which is right there. Get out something to help get those out of there. A little knife or scissors would work fine. 60. And we need lock washers too, which is 63 right here. And there's six of these lock washers. What you can do is have a little cup next nearby, or you could actually just take this whole thing and turn it upside down and leave them where they are. The one thing you don't want is what I'm trying to avoid doing is spilling them into your carpet, because then they will be very hard to find. We'll put them right over here. How's that for now? All right, one of those, two of those. Here's one hand threaded in first. So the reason why you hand thread something is so that you don't cross thread it. Using a tool, it's very easy to cross thread things. If you just use your hands, you can feel whether the threads are going right or not. Just a sense of touch. Once you get it going, now we need to get the Allen key out. 64, there it is right there. These are pretty complete directions. I like that. Not bad for 20 bucks. Screws, there we go. Check that every once in a while when you're using it so that you make sure that you're not gonna have it fall apart on you. Step two, we put these guys in there and we go 61, 63, and 65. So I can see what I'm doing. 61, 63 is over here, and 65 right there. We use two of them, two. And there's four 65s. Let's do the same thing with 65 that we did over there. And we'll just put two of them in with the lock nuts. Two, and we're doing 61. I like this. This kind of reminds me of when you were a kid. Remember you had paint by numbers and here's number 2. Here's number 61. That's violet. Now make sure to get these right. Here's the heads. And where's the, yeah, heads of screw. So heads up. This one goes down like, okay. And yes, I did not do any of this beforehand, so. This is all real time. Real time, real people. No animals were hurt during the filming of this broadcast. We have the lock knot and the cap knot. I guess we'll call that a cap knot. And we're gonna need another part here too. Hopefully these have the special, do this. Am I doing this right? I hope so. Yeah. I forgot. I didn't realize there's another hole up here. I could have made the mistake of going through. I was just grabbing any hole I could find. Now we're going to need another tool. Use your hand to hand tighten it. Time to open this guy up. Whenever possible, I like to use a ratchet instead of one of these tools that they provide with equipment, just because they're a little bit of a kludgy tool and it takes a while. I'd have this one on by now, and you can go down beyond it, which I just did, which if I had a
socket,
I wouldn't have to worry about this. I would just have it done and spin it, which will work better. Nice and tight. Now we're on to the other side. We have our technique now. So we're just gonna spin it, and our bar is taking shape. Finish tightening this nut. Part number 65. 65 is alive. Next, we're going to be putting on this part, which is the bar or whatever. Long bar, A bar. It's not as easy to put on as, all right, through, and goes like that with the foam up. They actually did it this way and like that. Oh, that helps your bars help. I can't talk this morning. The coffee has not kicked in yet, I guess. It's gonna be the last two of these and those, and then we're gonna be done. Wow, this goes fairly quickly. Be even quicker if I wasn't on camera. Now this piece right here is very important too. I'm not gonna be using this. This is for, you wedge this behind your molding to make sure you don't fall off the ledge. I'm not going to be using it for a chin-up bar. I already have chin-up bars in my doors. That will be a lot sturdier than that. There is a little square thing for the carriage bolt. It should be enough to hold it in place. That and the fact that you're going to be putting some pressure on it anyways. Why do they use such a long? There we go. We're in. Flip it over. Here's the last two parts going in. take that nut, put it on with your hand first before the wrench. Make sure that hand tight and then wrench tight. Using your hands so that you don't cross thread it. Whoops. We're almost done making this. Now we're done with the GG gear and we're gonna try this out. This looks like a fun piece of equipment. I'll let back you off some so that you can see the whole thing. Yay, we're done. We're all ready. Thing I like about this is that it's compact. Now, one thing I don't like right now is it's not totally square, so we're gonna have to see if we can fix that. Give it a little bit of tender love. Tighten everything up now that we're square. There's also on this instruction sheet, which I forgot to show you, is a whole bunch of exercises. GG gear. 40 plus exercises. Now, all of these exercises up here where you're in the upper part of the door frame, I'm not going to show you any of them. I'm primarily concerned with the exercises down here on the floor and in the door frame, the lower door frame. I intend to try them out. If you want to see some exercises, leave some comments down below. Who knows? I might post before the next 5 weeks. Love you all. Bye-bye. Yay!